So children, take your seats. Thank you. Thank you. Welcome again. As we are almost coming to an end of our day three, retreat of day three. I know God has still something in store for you, and I don't want to take much time. For like next 30 minutes, we want to continue hearing and hearing. The Bible says faith comes by hearing and by hearing. You don't just hear once. You hear and you hear and you hear and you hear and you hear until you believe it. So I know you are ready with your notebook and you are ready to hear from the Lord. How many are ready for the word of God? How many are ready for the word of God? Bans is already halfway. How many are ready for the word of God? Okay, now she's ready full. Thank you so much. Without wasting much time, I want to take this opportunity to welcome the servant of God that God has prepared for this afternoon. We want to have our last, but a bit, our evening service before we come to the end of our retreat day. So join me, people of God, as we welcome the servant of God. This is none other than Pastor Thomas. Let's clap to Jesus. Amen. Welcome, Pastor. Amen.
Thank you very much. This time we want to meditate the word of God from the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10, from verse 10 to 12. Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 10 to 12. I read it. Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 10 to 12. Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 10 to 12. I read it. And by that will we have been made holy through the sacrifice of the holy. Through the sacrifice of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. Day after day, every priest stands and performs his religious duties again and again. He offers the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But when this priest had offered for all time one sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God. And verse 14, because by one sacrifice he has made perfect forever those who are in faith holy. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. I mean, this is the talking about the sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. What does it mean? Religiously, And also, what can you say? According to the law, religious law, according to that, what is it, principle, spiritual principle, then Jesus died as a sacrifice once for all and for all of his life. That's why Jesus sacrificed on the cross, and then Jesus died on the cross. So, yeah, we need to know this, the meaning, the purpose of Jesus dying on the cross, and then the meaning of Jesus dying on the cross, yeah, correctly. So Jesus dying on the cross is this great purpose. This great purpose. So actually you can read from the book of Leviticus, chapter 16, from the last session, for the last session, Luke, Leviticus chapter 16, verse 20 to 22. Leviticus chapter 16, verse 20 and 22. It says that Leviticus chapter 16, from verse 20 to 22, it says that when Aaron had finished making atonement for the most holy place, the tent of meeting and the altar, he shall bring forward the live goat. He is to lay both hands on the head of the live goat and confess over it all the wickedness and rebellion of the Israelites, all their sins, and put them on the goat's head. He shall send the goat away into the desert in the care of a man appointed for the task. The goat will carry on itself at all their sins to a solitary place, and the man shall release it in the desert. So for the Israelites, they had this like a liturgy once per year. Once per year, they gathered at a place where all the people, the village people, they were surrounding. They were standing around the live goat, and they were confessing all their sins. God, I did this one, but nobody knows this one, but I commit sin this way. They all confess their sins. And they all their sins could be poured out on this boat. And then this boat, he was led to the outside of the castle. And then he was released outside of the castle, where the furious beasts were living. Then this goat was eaten by the beast. And then he died there, this goat, right goat. So he said that this is scapegoat. This goat carried all the sins, all the sins of the people in the village. And then he died there. John chapter 1, verse 29. John chapter 1, verse 29. When the John the Baptist saw Jesus, then John the Baptist was testifying for Jesus Christ, looking at Jesus. Actually, John the Baptist was cousin. John the Baptist was six months older than Jesus. Yeah. And then John the Baptist, but then this John the Baptist, he recognized Jesus as the Son of God, as the Christ. And then John the Baptist was testifying for Jesus. Verse 29. John chapter 1, verse 2 to 9. The next day, John saw, this is the God of practice. John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Look, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world." That's how Jesus life was. Jesus was the Lamb of God. And Jesus was the lion. Jesus was the eagle. But then the other image was Jesus was the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the whole world. So the Israelites, they had this witness, and they were confessing all their sins on the lion goat, on the scapegoat. And then the scapegoat, he was carried out, taken to the outside of the castle, and he died with all the sins of the village, and he died there, outside of the castle. Jesus took all the sins of the world, and he was carried to outside of the castle, and he died on the hill, Golgotha. That's how Jesus' life, Jesus' sacrifice was. So, we want to meditate, remember this grace of God again through Jesus Christ, sacrifice. So we go back to chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 10. And Hebrews chapter 10 from verse 10. And by that will we have been made holy through the sacrifice of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. So this Jesus was the Lamb of God. But then this Jesus sacrifice was not like the sacrifice of the animal. Verse 11. And the high priest, they were giving sacrifice before God every year. So day after day, maybe every day, they were giving sacrifice to God before God. Verse 11, day after day, every priest stands and performs his religious duties again and again. He offered the same sacrifices, which can never take away sin. Yeah, the priests, they were giving sacrifice to God with the life, with the animal, the real animals. But then the real animals, they cannot really take away the sins of the people. Yeah, maybe one time sin, a small sin, it could be taken away by the sacrifice of the animal. But then it cannot really take away all our sins. Fundamentally. But then verse 12, but when this priest had offered for all time one sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God. He offered himself for all time one sacrifice. This is important. Jesus' sacrifice was much more important, much more effective for all of this world. That's how Jesus was the Lamb of God. Jesus carried all the sins of the world, and then Jesus died on the cross with all our sins. So if we believe in Jesus Christ as our Lord, as our Savior, then we could die with Jesus, with our sins, on the cross. And then we can live again with what? With Jesus' resurrection. So, we want to think about this again. Verse 19 and 20. Therefore, brothers, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtains that is his body. That's how we can come before God directly. And then we can pray God directly through the way which Jesus opened Jesus cut, what is it? Jesus tore down the curtains. You know, there was a curtain between the holy place and the, what is it? Holy place and most holy place and holy place. There was a curtain. So then normal people, they could not enter the most holy place. But then when Jesus was dying, then what was happening? The Bible is recorded. The curtain was torn down. From up? I think from up. Yeah. The curtain was torn down from up. So then, not just the high priest, anybody who wants to come before God, they could come before God directly. With the what? With the power of what? With the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, we can come before God. We can confess our sins. Actually, you don't really need to really go before God through somebody. Through like archbishop, through the pastor. Even you can come before God directly. You can pray God directly. But through whom? With what power? With the power of Jesus Christ. As we believe that, Jesus died for my sins, we can come before God. Believing in this God, we can pray God with the name of Jesus Christ. So, we want to remember ourselves how much grace we receive. Jesus died for our sins once for all. Once for all. Jesus' sacrifice is different from the animal's sacrifice. But as Jesus was living according to the will of God, and he was pleasing to God, his life was pleasing to God, and then as he was sinless, pure sacrifice, perfect sacrifice. That's why Jesus' sacrifice could be the perfect sacrifice for the whole world. So we only need to believe in this. We don't need to something. We only, even you don't need to solve something. You solve something, then you go to heaven. No, that's not it. But you believe that Jesus died for my sins, then we can be accepted by God. This is the grace of God for our life. So you want to remember this. You want to remember this. So for my life then, maybe I started my faith, my life of faith around 25 years ago. And then, actually, I was also very simple, even though I was living the life of faith. But still, I was tempted a lot. I went to the bar many times. Even while I was going to the church. Even I was sometimes tempted by the beauty of the world. I was so simple. Even though maybe I was somehow good at academic things, but then I could not really find the meaning. I could not really find the true joy for my life in the world. But then instead of living the meaningful life, joyful life, but then I was trying to find the pleasure in the world. But then the pleasure, instead of giving me the true joy, it gave me more pain later. More pain. More regret. More regret. But then, even when I was in the sins, but then later I found that God is still calling me. God is still calling me. So then I realized then, this is the grace of God. It's not that God, Jesus died on the cross because I was good. But while I was still sinners. Why I was still doing the bad things? Jesus already died for all my sins. So this is the great grace of God. And then God was waiting for me with bare feet. So we need to believe in this. God is waiting for me. Even though today maybe because I'm weak for the temptation, but God is waiting for me. We need to believe that. Jesus died for all my sins. So God is waiting for me to come back from this sinful life and then to go back to His house, the Father's house. So God is waiting for us. So we want to believe in this. And then we want to come back to this house of God, my Father's house. We need to come back to by our Father's house. And then you will find the true joy, the true meaning for our life. So, and this time of Easter, we want to remember this great grace of God through Jesus Christ. And then we want to come back to Him. And then we really want to worship Him for the grace of God for our life. And then we can really, this time can be really, we want to really worship God. And then we also want to reveal the glory of God. And then we also want to let many people know this great heart of God for this world. So I want this time, especially as we go towards the Easter day, then we want to meditate this, the sacrifice of Jesus Christ dying on the cross. And then we really want to welcome the bright Easter in 2 days. So we want to end here. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for allowing us this time to meditate your word, to remove, to wash away our sins, to forgive all our sins. Then there should be blood shedding. So that is why many animals, they have to sacrifice their life to save, to forgive, to cleanse all our sins. But then Jesus Christ, as Jesus Christ, the Son of God, He came down to this world. He died on the cross. And He sacrificed His life as a redeeming sacrifice, as an atoning sacrifice for all our sins. So we want to accept this great love of God for our life. And then we want to realize that how God is loving us. And then how God is waiting for us, each one of us. So then as we come back to you, and then we want to realize your great love again. And then we also want to realize, receive the true love of God. And then we also want to live the new life in God, enjoy the true love and true joy, the true meaning for our life. So then our life can be revealing your glory. And then even our life can be fulfilling your will for this world. So please be with us, guide us, so that we can meditate your great love through Jesus Christ's sacrifice again. And then we can be renewed in God with the resurrection of Jesus Christ during God's time. So please be with us, guide each one of us continually, even guide the people in the world, so then many can realize your great love, and then many can also glorify your name through their life of faith. So thank you for your grace through this time, and I pray for this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pastor, for an eye-opener. We bless the Lord for that session. I was just asking myself when Pastor was speaking, up to now, if there was still sacrificing of animals, would we be having animals? At this time, animals were not enough. Up to now, there will be no animals. You can go to 4 or 5 homes and there is no animal. And Jesus took it all. Thank you for that wonderful session. And now, before we come to the end, maybe I just want to invite 1 or 2, 3 people. Maybe you have the share a reflection what we have learned today. But before we do so, we can end that session. Let's stand up on our feet. We end that session with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. 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 Thank you. You can take our seats.